Hi everyone, welcome to Trading in Zones. I hope you guys had a wonderful weekend, and this is a quick video to talk about some of the stocks which are coming up in the current week, which have been doing pretty well in the past week, what you can look for in terms of movement, and you know, some of the stocks which have kind of formed bearish momentum, and you can look for shorting opportunities. So if you look at V-Guard is one of these stocks which has had a significant volume, and you can see it is showing very significant breakout, and this was a point of breakout around 235. So we can continue to watch this stock. If it holds the level which it is created around 235 on any correction, then it becomes a great buy. But if it continues to move up and breaks the previous high, then it could also be a probable breakout trade right at around 245 plus. So watch out for these levels around 235 to 245 range. Could be a great range for having this stock in store, and looking forward to taking a trade and catching a good entry, because if the rally continues, this might make a certain new high. The other stock which is on my radar is obviously Ujjivan. Ujjivan also is a stock which this was a stock which I've been following somewhere from around 240 levels. I booked a good decent profit at around 320 odd when, you know, it gave a great rally here. I made a short term investment in this in the month of December. But however, if you are you know, looking at the stock now, you can see that it seems to be a breakout. So around 350 level seems to be the point of concern for this particular stock, and this seems to be breaking out now. So around 350 to 360, you can watch for price action in this coming week, and if it holds that particular level, this could be a good buy as well. The other stock which is obviously there is Berger Paint. Significant reaction post results and also crude prices going down could be a strong upside for the stock, and the new government making more housing schemes, etc., and stuff like that, the paint stocks might move significantly. So need to keep a watch, because this has gone and hit the resistance area. We need to wait and watch if it crosses 335, but if at all it retraces and if it starts holding around 316, 320 kind of level in this range between around 315 to 325, one can look at accumulating with a small stop loss right at around 310 or slightly below 310. So this is a good stock to watch as well. Apart from that, one of the reversal stories has been Edelweiss Finance, and we can see that the divergence has come into play right over here, and a good reversal patterns over here and also over here, and it seems to be reversing pretty strongly, and it seems to be gapping up as well. So it could be a possible good buy if it continues to hold the breakout which it has given. So around 199, you know, is a point of price action you may want to watch. If it supports, it can be a good intraday trade as well. But if it holds the region of around 190 to 199, this could be a good accumulation for a long-term return, because the stock might reverse significantly, given that it has fallen down a lot, and this seems to be kind of a breakout the stock is giving, and there is a probability that the stock might go all the way to around 250, 260 odd levels if it continues to move. Alright, so post Edelweiss, next comes is Yes Bank. So this was on a retrace, and also if you see the candlestick pattern on this small swing high, this has made a significantly bearish candle. So any kind of a reversal, this can create a short opportunity. Maybe 150, 149 levels can become a short opportunity for day traders, but for swing traders also, the moment it breaks this gap of around 146, this might start moving downwards to test the bottom of around 140, and it might again come down to test this demand which it got created and moved up to see if there is more interest in buying, or it might end up making a new low. We need to wait and watch, because the stock is significantly bearish and is not a stock recommendation to buy for sure. But however, this is a stock which one can look at intraday or a a short swing, a short side trade for a probable target of around 140, and the stop loss would be right above these levels, around 150 to 153. Can be a stop loss. Would recommend to short on reversal, not really short right when the market opens. Venky's is also a stock which was consistently falling and then showed a strong reversal, but there seems to be a bit of exhaustion right around 2000-2100, and then a pretty big sell-off which has happened in the last 2 days, especially Friday was a big fall. So right now, if we look at the way Venky's is going, maybe a 100 point fall is on the cards, and you might want to keep a watch on this. Again, a stock too short on retrace, not really jump in right when the market opens. One more point of reversal. This is a stock which I have been watching for quite some time. So you can see some of my analysis being here. This stock moved up from my past analysis. I was looking at this stock as a triangle breakout. It did give a very strong breakout at this point in time. So you can see this was a very strong ascending triangle which was in the kind of making, and it is almost at the same point taken the support on the trend line. And you can see it's created a very nice tweezer kind of a pattern, not technically tweezer, but almost something similar. And it is trying to move up. It's come into this gap fill, which was a big resistance, which got created when it fell down. So this seems to be reversing. So this can be a good stock to accumulate in this range. And if it continues to move, we might see around 840 levels again. So you can continue to accumulate the stock with a SL, on these levels, 721, 713. Right below that, you can have a stop loss, and you can continue to accumulate the stock in this area if it gives you an opportunity, or if it starts trending upside, you can continue to add on dips until you get a target of around 840, approximately around 830 to 840. Alright, so that's Tech Mahindra for all of you. Lastly, Nifty, lot of speculation in Nifty futures. People are expecting big falls, and most of the analysts are talking about falls. In my view, to be honest, it did create a strong bearish pattern which kind of happened over here. I looked at this as more of a reversal pattern, hangman coming into play and then a big red candle. But somehow it's not been able to break this level of around 11,830, which was seen even on Friday when a strong sell-off happened. This level came into play. So quite a few times this level's been responding pretty strongly, and at the same time, upside we can see around 960 has become a strong resistance, and the last trading session did not close above the previous session, which could also act as a resistance at around 940. So 940, 950, 960 approximate levels to watch for Nifty if at all it gives you a strong point of reversal to look for a shorting opportunity on top side, or if it gives you a price action opportunity to buy at the bottom side. For now, with the way Nifty has reacted multiple times when it has tried to make lows, when the market was swinging, around 11,700, 11,750 might be a point for us to watch. But however, in this kind of a situation, it's much easier to understand that yes, it is creating bearish patterns and multiple selling is happening at the top. So we need to wait and watch if it really crosses 11,960, 11,980 odd levels for it to move higher back up. If it doesn't, and if it fails anywhere while it's moving on top, can become a good shorting opportunity for a lot of traders. But a key level to watch is obviously around 11,800 to 11,830, which has been a very strong support. Once it breaks that, there is a very high probability of a continued down move on Nifty at this point in time. Alright, so thanks guys. So that's about it for the weekly talk. I hope this time including some charts is helping you out. Not much of fundamental picks. I didn't have much time. My apologies. Wouldn't be able to make many videos this particular week, but we'll try to make them up as we go through this week. I know I have my price action series pending This week I haven't been able to upload any price action series videos, but we'll. Alright, take care guys, have a wonderful week ahead.